Question number 13. On which of the following intervals is the function f given by f of x equal to x raised to 100 plus sin x minus 1 strictly increasing? So you have been given three intervals and the option none of these. You have to just check in which all intervals the function is strictly decreasing. That means you have to get f dashed of x is less than 0. If you are getting that, you can say that it is strictly decreasing. So we'll start with f of x and taking its derivative. F of x is x raised to 100 plus sin x minus 1. F dashed of x is 100 x raised to 99 n x raised to n minus 1 plus what is the derivative sign? Cos x, and derivative of 1 is 0. So you are getting 100 into x raised to 99 plus cos x as f dashed of x. Now we have to check for each interval. Okay, so first we are taking in 0, 1. Now in 0, 1, whatever value you substitute, you can say that 100 into x raised to 99 will be greater than 0, correct? Now what about cos x? Now cos x means anyway, whatever value we substitute for x should be in radians. So 0 and 1 are actually radians. So 1 radian means it is approximately 57 degrees. Okay, so 0 is okay. Cos 0 you can just define, and that is positive also. And you can just see that this interval will become like 0 and 57 degrees. 0 degree and 57 degrees. So cos is positive in between these values. You can say that cos x is also greater than 0. Therefore, f dashed of x is greater than 0 because it is a sum of these two. So you will get f dashed of x is greater than 0. That means the function is strictly increasing. Increasing in the interval 0, 1. Now we will go for the second interval, which is pi by 2, comma pi. Again, pi by 2 and pi means you can just see that it is in the second quadrant. Pi by 2, comma pi is in the second quadrant and cos value is negative, right? Cos is negative in the second quadrant. Cos negative in the second quadrant. So cos x will be less than 0. Now what about 100 x raised to 99? Again, pi by 2 means pi is mod just 22 by 7. If you go for the values, you have to check, no, this is positive or negative for that. And pi by 2 will be 22 by 7 by 2. That is into 2 in the denominator. So it will give you 11 by 7 in the denominator. It is 7. Okay, so 11 by 7 is your pi by 2 and pi is 22 by 7. So whatever value that is positive only, so you will get 100 x raised to 99 is also greater than 0. So this is greater than 0 and this is less than 0. But the max minimum value, if it is less than 0, then also the minimum value of cos is minus 1. Right? So negative value means it will go till negative 1. And 100 x raised to 99 is more than that. You can say that 100 x raised to 99 is greater than cos x for this interval. 100 x raised to 99 will be greater than cos x. That means you will get this to be a positive quantity only, because this is greater than this value. This plus this, that means this will become minus. Then also it is giving you the to the maximum and minus 1. So you can say that the total, that is your 100 x raised to 99 plus cos x will be greater than 0 only. Okay, therefore your f dashed of x is greater than 0 in this interval, that is f is again strictly increasing in the interval pi by 2 comma pi. Okay, even if cos is negative, this value will be greater than cos value, therefore the total will give you positive only. Hence the function is strictly increasing in the interval. In this interval, when you see 100 x raised to 99, this is again 0 and 11 by 7. Okay, 11 by 7, that is 22 by 7 into 2 will give you 11 by 7. Okay, so this, in this interval, what you are getting, 100 x raised to 99 is again greater than 0. Now again, this is in if you say quadrant wise it is your first quadrant, and in first quadrant cos is positive for any value, right? So you will have cos x is also greater than 0, and combining these two you will have f dashed of x is greater than 0. That means f is again strictly increasing in the interval 0 pi by 2. So you have been given three intervals. In all the three intervals you are getting the function to be strictly increasing. Therefore the option D is correct, that is none of these. Therefore option D, none of these is the correct option. Okay. Question number 14 is, find the least value of a such that the function f given by f of x equal to x square plus ax plus 1 is strictly increasing on the interval open 1, 2. So they have given that the function is increasing in this interval, and you have to find out for the value of a, for the least value of a for which this condition is satisfied. That means we can take f dashed of x is greater than 0. Okay. So f of x is x square plus ax plus 1. Now what will be f dashed of x? It will be 2x plus a into 1. Derivative of x is 1. So 2x plus a is your f dashed of x. Now they are saying that f dashed of x is, this is given in the question, f dashed of x is greater than 0 for any x which is in the open interval 1, 2. That means 2x plus a is greater than 0 for any x in 1, 2. Now in order to find out the value of a, what we are doing is we will start with this, that is x belongs to interval 1, 2, means 1 less than x less than 2, correct? Now we are just going for this, that is making this term as this one. So we are starting with 1 less than x less than 2 because x belongs to 1, 2. We are checking in this interval. Now what we are doing is we are multiplying throughout by 2 in order to get this term 2x plus a. First we will multiply throughout by a, sorry, 2. So you'll get 2 less than 2x less than, this will become 4. Now next thing is you have to add a throughout. So this will become 2 plus a less than 2x plus a less than 4 plus a. Why? Because we have this condition for 2x plus a is greater than 0, and we are just applying here in order to get what is a. Okay. So here what you are getting is this term is greater than 0. Just check. 2x plus a is greater than 0. That means it is lying in between, means this should be greater than 0, this should be greater than 0. Okay. So what you will do, 2 plus a is greater than 0, and you can say 4 plus a is greater than 0. It is lying in between these two values, and this is positive, means this is the condition which you are getting. Because here it is less than, it is greater than. That means 2 plus a should also be greater than 0, then only this is greater than 0. Okay. Now from this you will get a is greater than minus 2, a is greater than minus 4. So the question is, the least value for which a is giving you the function to be strictly increasing on 1, 2 will have a is greater than minus 2. Because this is the minimum value for which you will get. Least value means isse bada agar value, if you are substituting, that will make the function to be not strictly increasing. So you will get that if a is greater than minus 2. Let I be an any interval disjoint from minus 1, 1. Now suppose this is your R, real number line. Disjoint from open minus 1, 1 means this is minus 1, this is 1. That means it is not having any value which is here. Disjoint from minus 1, 1 means till this. Or I can write I is equal to R minus open minus 1, 1. Okay, this is I. That means it can have 1 and minus 1, but not in between any value. That is minus 1 and 1 ke beech mein, you don't have any values there for your I, interval I. Remaining every values it can take. This is the meaning of I is an interval which is disjoint from minus 1, 1. All the other values in the real number system will be taken by I. Okay, and you have to prove that the function given by f of x is equal to, so this is given, I is given like this, f of x is equal to x plus 1 by x is strictly increasing on I. So again you will start with f dashed of x, which is derivative of x 1, derivative of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. You can just check whether you are getting this or not. Okay, and what they are saying, you have to prove that it is strictly increasing. For that, we will just equate it to 0 and find out the actually those values, right? This I am just writing it as x square, and this is x square minus 1 after taking LCM, so that I can make it as x plus 1 into x minus 1. Not necessary, you can check here also. This is only for ease of calculation, that whether this is giving positive or negative, because anyway x square will give you positive. Whatever value you give for x, x square will be positive. Now you have to check for this only. Now what they have said, according to this, the interval becomes like minus infinity, minus 1. We need not go for equal to 0 and find out. Here also you can just see, you will get 1 and minus 1, the breakage as. If you substitute this as 0, you will get your x to be 1 and minus 1. So this will be the breakage. But again, you will not have minus 1, 1, because that is not included here. So you will get only this interval and 1 infinity in this question. Okay, so first we are checking in the interval minus infinity minus 1. For what? For f dashed of x. What will be the value of f dashed of x? So let us suppose we are taking x is in between a value minus 2. Suppose x is minus 2. What will be f dashed of x? Just check f dashed of x. Here this will give you minus 2 plus 1, which is negative. Here you will have minus 2 minus 1, which is again negative. Divided by, this will be always positive only. So you are getting actually minus 2 minus plus. Positive means it is greater than 0. Right? So you can say that f is, since f dashed of x is greater than 0 in this interval, f is strictly increasing in the interval. Again, you have to write open. It is not taken. That is, minus 1 is not included here. Okay? Now for the other interval, that is 1 infinity, suppose x is 2, okay, if you are substituting any number in between 1 and infinity, you will get f dashed of x to be, first part you just check, 2 plus 1 is positive, 2 minus 1 is also positive, and the denominator is always positive. So you are getting again positive, which is greater than 0. That is, f is strictly increasing in this interval also. In the interval 1 infinity. So altogether what you got in both the intervals, which is I, the function is strictly increasing. Therefore, the function is strictly increasing on I. Okay. So therefore, f is strictly increasing on I. What is I? It is not having this value. That means this value. So you can say that in both these intervals, since it is, so this combination of this is your I. Okay, so it is increased, strictly increasing on I. Prove that the function f given by f of x equal to log sine x is strictly increasing on 0 pi by 2 and strictly decreasing on pi by 2. Pi. So first we will start with what is f dashed of x. Log of sine x will give you 1 by sine x into derivative of sine x, which is cos x. So you are getting it to be cot x. Okay, f dashed of x is cot x. Now what you have to check? You have to check for these two intervals. They have already given the intervals. So 0 pi by 2. 0 pi by 2 may, what is it doing? That is it strictly increasing or strictly decreasing, you have to check, and in the other interval whether it is strictly decreasing or increasing. So first we will take in 0 pi by 2. In 0 pi by 2 means 0 to 90, you can take any value. Suppose x is pi by 4. What you are getting your f dashed of x to be? F dashed of pi by 4, which is cot pi by 4. What is cot pi by 4? 1. So you are getting f dashed of x to be greater than 0. Therefore, f is strictly increasing in the interval 0 pi by 2. Now for the other thing, that is in pi by 2 comma pi, suppose what you are taking your x to be, pi by 2 to pi, 120 you can take. एनी वे यू कैन जस्ट चेक लाइक दिस ऑल्सो, इट इज इन द सेकेंड क्वाड्रेंट. वॉट इज इन द सेकेंड क्वाड्रेंट? कॉट एज कॉट इज नेगेटिव बिकॉज टैन इज नेगेटिव. सो इवन इफ यू आर नॉट सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग एनी वैल्यू फॉर कन्वीनियंस, यू कैन चेक लाइक दिस ऑल्सो. इन द सेकेंड क्वाड्रेंट इन दिस इंटरवल cot x is less than 0, that is f dashed of x is less than 0, which implies that the function is strictly decreasing in the interval pi by 2 comma pi. Here also, if you say this is the first quadrant, in this first quadrant cot will be positive only. Cot will be positive means f dashed is positive, therefore it will be strictly increasing. Prove that the function f given by f of x equal to log cos x is strictly decreasing on 0 pi by 2 and strictly increasing on pi by 2 comma pi. So first we will start with f of x equal to log cos x. What will be f dashed of x? Log cos x will give you 1 by cos x into derivative of cos x, which is minus sin x. So it is minus tan x. Okay, f dashed of x is minus tan x. Now what we need to check? In the interval 0, pi by 2, you have to check for tan. Again, you know that in this interval, tan x is positive. Any function, any trigonometric function, all the trigonometric functions are positive in the first quadrant. 0 to pi by 2 means it is the first quadrant, all positive. So you'll get tan x is also positive. But when you say for minus tan x, the function f dashed of x is minus tan x, this will be less than 0. That means you'll get f dashed of x is less than 0. And therefore, you can say that f is strictly decreasing on 0 pi by 2. Now, for the second thing, that is in the interval pi by 2 comma pi, what can you say about tan x? Tan x is negative. Tan is negative in the second quadrant. So your tan x is less than 0, but your function f dashed of x is minus tan x. Negative of that will give you again opposite. The inequality will reverse its direction and this will give that f dashed of x is greater than 0. So f is strictly increasing in which interval we have checked? In pi by 2 comma pi. Okay,